for us at the Swans, we always thought that we were doing a fair bit of work for the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander communities, and we respected that. But we really didn't have anything in place that sort of showed us how we were participating across that. And I suppose what the RAP does for us is it outlines what we, the great work we have been doing, but also the work that we can do in the future. And having a, you know, a three-year document that outlines what we plan to do, how we're going to achieve it, and who's responsible for that is just it's just amazing.
I presume it's a work in progress. You talk about 3 years, but do we look ahead to where the RAP plan can go?
Yeah, of course. I think something that, you know, I'm really happy about with the RAP is, you know, in the 3 years, that every person at the Sydney Swans, staff and players, are going to have access to cultural awareness programs and sessions. And hopefully at the end of that three-year period, that everyone will have 100% success, that everyone's gone through that. And to me, the education side to that is just overwhelming, that people are going to get that opportunity to learn more about who I am, my people are, who the Gadigal people are, what is the Eora Nation. So these are the types of things that I'm really looking forward to passing on. But another thing is just that Michael's part of as well was the Indigenous talent stream that we're going to create through the RAP, and that's through the Swans Academy. So to try and get as many Aboriginal players, hopefully from New South Wales, coming through the junior ranks, coming through the Swans Academy, and hopefully playing close to 300 games like Michael and myself.